Coming up, I'll walk you through the Windows 10 Creators Update for Surface Hub, including the new welcome screen, start menu, and intelligent whiteboard experiences. Single sign-on for easier access to your content, office apps, and personal meetings, and improvements to ending your session and more. And for IT professionals, I'll walk you through new ways to deploy and manage Surface Hub at scale with new settings. We've been in market for over a year now. Surface Hub is our large screen group collaboration device with video conferencing, wireless content sharing, and whiteboarding. Surface Hub runs Windows 10 applications and the Edge browser. Many of you are starting to deploy the Surface Hub at scale, and with the Windows 10 Creators Update for Surface Hub, we've incorporated your feedback to enhance your experience, whether you're a user or an IT admin. Let's start with the updates we made to the user experience. One of the first things you'll notice is the update to the welcome screen. I can use the new meeting carousel to see if there's any meetings about to happen on this hub. And this is especially useful for those devices deployed outside of the conference room, in team or in huddle spaces, because I can see how much time I have to use the device before someone else needs it. As before, I can one-touch join an existing Skype meeting, start a new Skype meeting, use the whiteboard, or use the Connect app to start projecting to the hub. And as we move to the bottom of the welcome screen, you'll notice that you can sign in directly to the Surface Hub. This will simultaneously sign you into Office 365 and allow you to quickly access your cloud content and personal meetings. Once logged in, you'll notice that the start menu has changed as well. From here, I'm able to access the default hub apps. And from here, I'm able to access the list of IT provisioned apps. As you can see, since I've already signed on, I have access to my personal meetings, as well as a list of my most recently used files. I can easily access my content from the cloud and with single sign-on start collaborating. In fact, I have an office floor plan here I want to further brainstorm with the team. I can easily grab this and place this directly into the whiteboard. There are a few things to notice about the whiteboard. You'll notice that there are new ink and ink effects as part of the refreshed whiteboard experience. Just like before, it's very quickly for me to get started and annotate. With the new highlight feature, I'm able to make highlights so my team can look into it later. I can also use the new ruler tool to easily draw straight lines to divide this room up here in half. Once I'm done, I can also add new doors so my teammates know where to start working. Using the intelligent new ink to shape feature, as I start to draw a square, the whiteboard recognizes the shape that I'm starting to draw and automatically smooths out the lines, thus creating a perfect square. And coming soon, we are adding the ability to do simultaneous hub-to-hub co-authoring on the whiteboard so remote participants can collaborate with each other in real time. Now let me show you how easy access to my meetings and content comes together. I can either load the Skype app from the start menu, or since I've already signed in to the hub, I can sign in directly to one of my personal meetings here. I'm gonna hop on a call with Lydia right now. Once the call starts, you'll notice that we've updated the Skype UI. This gives me easier access to the core Skype menu items at the bottom of the screen, and it frees up more space to display and share your content in the meeting, as you can see here from the Excel file that Lydia is sharing. Finding content to share is also much easier. Lydia is referencing a market opportunity plan that I should look at. Instead of asking her to send it over, I can go to the Office portal to find the document she is referring to. As I go to Edge to access the Office portal, I'm immediately signed in since I signed in earlier. I can access all of my Office experiences like email or even Delve. This will help me find the file that Lydia was mentioning, so long as I have permission to access it. I can quickly access her market segment file, and once again, it's a seamless experience accessing the file. I did not have to authenticate due to my single sign-on, which means I can get to the content directly. Lastly, now that I've completed what I came here to do, I can more easily end my session at the center of the screen, which means that I can get to it no matter which side of the screen I'm on, or I can end the session directly from the start menu. Once selected, this signs me out of the Surface Hub. I can walk away knowing that my credentials are cleared, my apps are closed, and no one will be able to see what I did on the whiteboard because the device is automatically reset for the next user. So now let's switch gears and talk about the updates to the IT administration experience in the Windows 10 Creators Update for Surface Hub. The Surface Hub can be managed across a spectrum of cloud, hybrid, and on-premises environments. Let me show you the simplified first run experience for getting multiple devices set up in just a few clicks. This is useful if you have a lot of Surface Hubs in a single location. I have already prepared a USB drive with everything on it that I need to configure each Surface Hub. It contains things like settings, the list of device names, passwords, and corresponding display names for the hub in my location, so I don't have to type these details in as I move from hub to hub. You'll see here that the hub has automatically recognized the configuration, and I'm prompted to follow through the steps. I acknowledge that I'll be using a USB, and here I'll pick the package that I want to load onto this hub. Here I'm presented with the device name for this hub. From here I can select, and I'll be able to choose a list that I've prepared already on the USB as to which hub I want to use. For this hub in this room, I'm going to use a Rainier Surface Hub. Once I've selected the device information I want to use, I can hit Next. After hitting Next, all the configurations will be applied, and the hub will reboot. At this point, I can remove the drive and move on to the next Surface Hub if I want. Once all the settings are applied, the hub will turn itself back on and automatically complete the process. Lastly, the Creators Update gives you several new settings, a few of which I'd like to highlight include the ability to use the device account's credentials for authentication. If your company policy requires it, you can now use the device account's credentials to authenticate directly to Exchange. And you can also persist your proxy settings across sessions. Another new setting allows you to customize the device reset for timeout. This setting allows me to select how long until the screen goes idle. And from here, I'm able to select the behavior, which will allow a user to resume the session after the screen goes idle, or I'm able to end the session after it goes idle, which will ensure that all my data is cleaned. Of course, as before, all of our features can be enabled or disabled via MDM for larger scale deployments. So that was a quick tour of some of the highlights of Windows 10 Creators Update for Surface Hub. You can learn more about Surface Hub and access a full list of our features in our user and admin guides in the links below. And don't forget, we're listening. So if you have questions or feedback, please engage on our Surface Hub tech community. Thanks for watching.